Welcome back to Cooking with B. On this week's video, we're going to be doing a Greek chicken sandwich that's inspired by the Gyro. So come cook with me. So for the chicken sandwich, we're gonna need the following ingredients. So obviously we're gonna be using some chicken breast. We're gonna be using some feta. Of course, our favorite tomatoes, the Campari tomatoes. We're going to be using some store-bought tzatziki, which is a cucumber garlic dill sauce that's made with cucumber yogurt. If you feel inspired, you can go ahead and make your own. I just buy it. We're going to marinate the chicken in some Greek dressing as we prepare the rest of the ingredients. And then we're going to thinly slice up a red onion. We're going to get the oven going and toast up a little bit of pita bread so it's nice and warm and flexible. And then finish it off with just a little bit of romaine hearts or whatever lettuce you have in the fridge. So those are today's ingredients. So what we've gone ahead and done is we've got a warming feature on our oven that sets it at a 200 degree temperature. So we've gone ahead and started that oven. Like I said, we've got our store-bought Greek dressing. And I just put a little bit of that on the bottom of our glass dish. Start cutting up our chicken and we'll add a little bit more in a little bit. So for our chicken, you got a couple different ways you can do it. The way I like to do it is just the old standard cutlet. So don't get off those yucky fat pieces. Hold your hand down on the side and then slowly saw back and forth. And then you should get a nice, even cut. So that's that. Put that in our marinating dish. Keep going with the rest of them. All right. So you can see that just took a quick moment to go ahead and just cutlet up those three chicken breasts. I'm just gonna take a couple more tablespoons of the Greek dressing and just do a quick marinade. And then we'll set that aside and work with our vegetables. So there you go. We've gone ahead and reset. We washed our hands. New cutting board, new knife. All right, so when we got home from the grocery store, we went ahead and cleaned our vegetables. So we're gonna go ahead and just make some nice thin slices so that they stay in the sandwiches. So that was four Campari tomatoes. Or probably two good size beefsteak tomatoes or a couple plum tomatoes, whatever is your favorite. Next, let's go ahead and do the red onion. So we had cheeseburgers yesterday, so I had a red onion left over. So I'm just gonna use what I can off of it. So with this, the key is to get as thin a slice as you can get. You don't want the red onion to be overpowering. So you really, really want paper thin slices. My boys are not big onion fans, so we're not gonna need a lot. Let's see, just paper thin. More. The other nice part about these sandwiches is everybody can customize what they like and don't like. So. Feta. Now this is not something that I found is typical in a gyro. I like having that little bit of extra flavor, that extra punch from the Greek cheese. So what we're gonna do is just cut it into little cubes. Reassemble it the right way. All right, we have a dog begging. She heard the word cheese. And again, you can buy it in the block style, or you can buy it already crumbled up. This one just happened to be on sale this week, so that's why I bought the brick. Okay. You just want a rough cut. This week we were having Cobb salad, so we just went with romaine. But again, you can go with whatever your favorite lettuce is. So I'm just cutting the end off, half and half. Boom. And again, this was already washed from when we got home at the grocery store. All right. So get this off to the side and let's start cooking that chicken. So we did a quick marinade on our chicken, probably about 15 minutes or so. Now let's start getting it cooking. And because we used the salad dressing, it already has a little bit of olive oil in it, so there's no need to put any olive oil inside the pan. We've gone ahead and put our pitas in the oven, so those are warming as we speak. We have all our veggies chopped, ready to go. Now it's just gonna make that chicken. And hot to me. Put a bit of that marinade on both sides. Ooh, that's what you want to hear. And we can probably do a nice little one. To zhuzh up the flavor a little bit, we're gonna add a little bit of our garlic and herb all-purpose seasoning. You don't wanna crowd the pan when cooking anything, especially if you want it to get a nice golden crust. And then we're gonna cook this for about 2 minutes per side, and then it should be good. All right, go ahead, give it a nice flip. Ooh, you can smell the garlic and seasonings coming through. Yummy. Give a little love to this side. So I've already gone ahead and switched to a clean pair of tongs because you don't want to cross-contaminate raw chicken with cooked chicken. So as you can see, these are cooking lovely. Pan, of course, has some hot spots, so we're just gonna finish these off. You can tell this one still has a few more minutes, where this one is looking good. Alright, that one's done. We're gonna put it off to rest. Let this guy cook a little bit more. Let's go assemble our sandwiches. So what we did is we let the chicken rest for about 10 or 15 minutes. That way it stays nice and juicy when we cut it open. So let's go ahead and start assembling our sandwich. We have one of our pita pockets just out of the oven. So you can see when you do that, it makes it nice and flexible. So personally, how I do it, start with a little tzatziki. Make a nice good dollop of that right in the middle. Spread that out. And then I like to take my chicken, my lettuce for the bed for my chicken. I like to cut up my chicken in nice little thin strips. That way it's not falling out everywhere as I'm trying to eat. You can see how nice and juicy and tender that is. Chicken is just falling apart. Red onion. Again, you don't want it to overpower, so just a couple. And some of those thin sliced tomatoes. Ooh, can't forget the feta. Went ahead and made sure that we had some good feta for this. Just put a couple chunks in there. And that will really kick up the flavor you'll find. That's it. And again, you can customize it however you want, but to me that just smells like summer. I love Greek food. I love the garlic and the oregano smell of everything and the freshness that the tomato gives. So let's go ahead and take a bite. See, by warming up that pita, everything doesn't crack open. That's one happy Becky. That's a good sandwich. Oh, be careful, it's drippy with the tomatoes. So, this is one of our family favorites. Hopefully it will become one of yours. We are very, very close to hitting 100. So once I hit 100 subscribers, I will randomly pick one of my followers and we will give them a nice Amazon gift certificate. So definitely go ahead and like and subscribe and share. And hopefully we can get to 100 shortly. Thanks, everyone. Be well.